Assalamu alaikum, dear sisters. Today I want to talk to you about the dua. Every human being on this planet at some point of their lives makes a dua to Allah, realizing it or not, even if they're not Muslims. Everyone wishes for something or asks for something or asks for ease when they are in difficulties. That act in itself is called dua. When we turn to Allah and when we ask Allah for something in particular, that is called dua, and that is an ibadah or something that all the Muslims are encouraged to do, and all the prophets and messengers of Allah have done in their lives. It is very important that we also do it. But how to implement gratefulness into our duas? That is what I'm going to tell you today. A few weeks ago, I was writing an email, and at the bottom of the email, I wrote, "Thank you in advance for your help," because I knew that the person on the other side will do their best to help me, and therefore I thanked them in advance, although I didn't have any results from them yet. So we can do the same with Allah. When we are sure that Allah will answer our duas, we can of course thank Him in advance for that, because sometimes He does answer our duas, but we even forget to thank Him about it after we get it. We forgot that we have made that dua and that we want it so badly, that thing, and we even forget to thank sometimes. So why not thank when we are still doing it? And also, we should remember that Allah never returns the hands empty of a believer who asks Allah for something. Allah will always fill our hands with something and will always answer our duas in some way or another. For example, He will answer the dua in the way that we have asked Him for, in the manner that we imagined that's how we want the things to happen, and He will give us that. Or He will give us something better for us, actually, because not everything we ask for is actually good for us, and therefore Allah will give us something better. In the third way, He may answer us that He will give us something better, but in the hereafter. So we will not see the result in this dunya, but we will see it in the afterlife, inshallah. So as I said, Allah will never return our hands empty. And in order to implement that gratefulness when we make a dua, we can do the following thing, and that is the exercise I have for you for today. Think about 5 or 10 things that you need right now, or that you need improvement with right now, and sit and write them down. But write them in this manner. Say first 3 times, Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah. Really feel that Allah will answer your dua, and then write the rest. For example, if right now you don't have a job and you're looking for one, then first of all, thank for all the things that you have had in the past provided by Allah. So you can write it in this way. Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah for all the halal income that I have had in the past and the halal jobs that I have worked. And Alhamdulillah for the opportunity to be able to look for a new job right now, and for the halal income that I will have in the future. And you can do that for the rest of the things. Also, once you write them, read them again and imagine that Allah has already responded in the best way to your duas and wishes. Live in the feeling that everything has already been sorted for you, and remember that feeling. And every time when you turn to Allah, know that He will respond to you in the best way for yourself. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And may Allah accept all your good duas. Ameen.